Have you ever wondered how a plastic water bottle gets recycled? There's a few steps involved that take a plastic water bottle like this and turn it into a brand new one. It's really interesting, and I want to show you from start to finish just how it's done.
I love recycling and I do my best to recycle every chance I get. So when I'm at home and I have a plastic bottle, it goes right in my recycle bin instead of the trash can. I don't want to end up in the landfill because that's just a waste of a great resource. Every week, I dump our recyclable items in our curbside bin for the recycling service to take away. Our bin is blue, but your recycle bin might be brown or green in your city. Not every waste hauler can sort recyclables from trash, so it's important to separate those items before they're picked up. Putting it in the right bin is so easy, and it's the first step to making sure this material gets used over and over again. It's a small step that can make a big difference. Many waste haulers like ours take the recyclable items to a material recovery facility, MRF for short, or partner with a local recycling facility to separate the materials. This twister machine is compressing these plastic beverage bottles, referred to as PET number 1, which is short for polyethylene let's call it PET number 1 for short. It's a super common and recyclable plastic used for products like water bottles and other containers. It's the most recycled plastic in the world, and it can be recycled into new products like carpet fibers, ropes, or even new bottles. Our local recycling center takes our plastic bottles and compresses them to save space before they get baled up. I love seeing the bottles get squished. Once the plastic bottles have been compressed through the twister, they get compressed again and baled up for transport. This step is super cool because the loose bottles all get taken up the conveyor belt and dumped into a baling machine, which compresses it even more into large bales that weigh about 1,000 pounds each. As you can see, there are all sorts of colors and different types of beverage containers being squished together. What's important is that they are all the same types of plastic. These will eventually all get separated by color and type before being shredded. Every once in a while, an aluminum soda can or milk jug made from HDPE plastic gets mixed in here with PET by accident. But that's okay because it gets removed before being shredded. My favorite part of the step is seeing the large bales being pushed out of the machine. It gets wrapped tightly with thin wires into bales and stacked for transport. Once enough bales of plastic have been made, they are loaded onto a truck and taken to a processor where all the magic happens. My friend Robert is a pro on the forklift. He makes it look so easy to pick up 3,000 pounds of plastic at one time. My local recycling center does this daily, so he gets a lot of practice. Once everything's all loaded up, this truck will hold 46 bales, which is approximately 46,000 pounds of plastic. Now that's a lot of plastic that gets to be recycled and turned into something new. See you later, bottles. See you at the processor. At the processor, the bales get their containing wires cut and are loaded onto the conveyor belt into the machine that breaks them back down into individual bottles. By the time the bottles get to this point, they're about as squished as they can be. They've been twisted, compacted, and now they're about to be shredded. At this processing center, the bottles are examined as they go down the line, and any items that aren't supposed to be there are pulled out to be recycled separately. This might be that occasional milk jug or soda can I mentioned earlier. These workers are on the lookout for anything that is a different type of material or even different colors. Some processing centers use AI-powered robotic sorters for this step. I'm helping dump green containers that will get shredded separately. Clear plastic bottles can be recycled into any color bottle, but these green bottles have a green pigment that is a permanent additive. During the recycling process, green, brown, and blue bottles are typically separated from clear bottles and are often downcycled into other products like plastic lumber, carpeting, and clothing. After the bottles get shredded, the tiny pieces get soaked in a hot bath to remove all the old labels and any adhesive on the bottles. This water is treated to remove all the gunk and gets reused. The skimmed off label waste also gets recycled. The clean plastic flakes get dried and blown into large storage bags like this one. This bag will be filled with 2,500 pounds of clean flake material ready to be sent to a manufacturer. While some processors will use these flakes to make new products, others will melt and extrude them to form strips that are then cut into pellets. Plastic flakes and pellets are the two most commonly used base materials for producing water bottles and other plastic items that we use every day. Once at the manufacturer's plant, the tiny plastic flakes or pellets like these get melted down and fed into a machine like this to extrude preforms, which will become a water bottle. These little things get heated up so the plastic is pliable and high pressure air is blown into it to create the water bottle shape we're used to seeing. The manufacturer uses another type of recycled plastic called HDPE to make the caps. HDPE is the same material used in most water gallon containers and milk jugs. This machine is setting up the caps before they get on the bottles. I learned that many bottlers, like where I was at, disinfect the water with ozone, a gas that kills bacteria. Ozone is dissolved into the water just before it's bottled. Over time, the ozone breaks down and reverts to oxygen. The bottles go into a big rotary filling machine that fills them with clean water. This process is really cool to see. The water is not typically chilled during this process. If the bottles were filled with cold water, it could cause condensation to form on the outside of the bottle, which would interfere with the application of labels. The outside surface of the bottles must be dry to ensure the labels stick properly. Once the bottles are filled and caps are applied, they are pushed down the line for inspection. Any rejected bottles get taken out of the line and dumped into bins so they can get recycled again. I asked what kind of things might make a bottle get rejected and learned that bottles might get too much air pressure or not enough when it's sealed. It might also have a faulty cap or an issue with the label. If it's not perfect, it gets rejected. Some bottles get printed, labels applied, and some bottles don't. This particular brand is actually using a new design that has all the information molded right into the plastic bottle, so you don't need a label. Something else super cool is that all these bottles I'm looking at here are made using 100% recycled plastic. Pretty cool, right? All the bottles get packaged up into cases and put onto pallets, and then shipped out to distributors and retailers. The facility I toured in Rialto, California is one of the biggest in the world, and they have some of the most advanced bottling capabilities of anywhere. It was really impressive to see. Simple acts like recycling your water bottles make a big difference when we all do it together.